Good afternoon. We are glad you're with us today for our final Lenten Community musical concert. Today, we welcome Susan and Scott Eddlemon. They were with us last year and did a wonderful job, so we're thrilled to welcome them back this year. They are musicians with the Symphony of the Mountains. Scott was actually the director, but had to step down because they're moving to Wisconsin, so Scott can complete his seminary degree to be ordained in the Anglican Church. How do you say the name of the cemetery you're going to?
Nashota House.
Mm-hmm. Nashota House. There you go. So we are thrilled to have them back. And friends, I invite you to listen to God's word as it comes to us today through the beautiful music of Susan and Scott. So the first thing you'll, after the piece gets going, you'll notice the birds celebrate her return with a festive song. And that sounds something like this. Sounds something like this. And then it's not long until the spring thunderstorms hit. The second movement takes place on a flower-strewn meadow with leafy branches rustling overhead, sounding something like this. Meanwhile, the goat herd sleeps under a tree and is dreaming like this. Favorite part, it says here in the score, il cane che grida, which apparently means the faithful dog sleeps at his side, slightly snoring. So it's like this. It's an amazing dog because it always snores in tune. I'll just mention in the last movement, it's the festive sound of rustic bagpipes, nymphs, and shepherds lightly dance beneath the brilliant canopy of spring. And piano can never do justice to the orchestra part, but he has the bagpipe part in the
sometimes in the music. So that's Vivaldi's Spring. We'll play the three movements now.
Thank you. Thank you. It is my privilege every week during this series, to have the benediction. I will say the same thing on behalf of those here. We thank you for elevating our spirits through music. And I've known these people for a long time. But I've been on boat trips with them, So there. And we've got another boat trip along with David and Charles coming up. I always look forward to those. Charlotte had this framed and had an original watercolor by Betty Skaggs, a local artist. And to see this, you would probably think it's about a pine tree, right? Since you got a picture of a pine tree. Well, it's not. And the first line in it mentions a pine tree, but it's still not about a pine tree. The text is by Georgia Harkness, who is generally accepted to be the most prominent female theologian in America in the last 100 years. And the poem is about her father, who obviously was deceased. So you hear this today through your own life experience. A giant pine, magnificent and old, stood staunch against the sky, and all around she had beauty, grace, and power. Within its fold, birds safely reared their young. The velvet ground beneath was gentle, and the cooling shade gave cheer to passers-by. Its towering arms a landmark stood, erect and unafraid, as if to say, fear not from life's alarms. It fell one day. Where he had dauntless stood was loneliness and void. But men who passed paid tribute, said, to know this life was good, it left its mark on me. Its work stands fast. And so it lives. Such life no bonds can hold, this giant pine, magnificent and old. And all God's people said, amen.